this evening, including the Wangs and the Kings from the JLA in Detroit. Now, not since his father's unfortunate aneurysm just about 2 weeks ago had Wayne Gretzky put on the Blades. But tonight, he returned to his team. Now, without Gretzky, the Kings are a solid but not spectacular club. So far this season, 5-3-2, good enough for only fourth place in the Smythe. Let's see if his return spurred on Los Angeles as we go to the JLA, and the great one was not in great form tonight. But he had a pretty solid game with a score of 1-0 for Detroit. The Kings tied up. Taylor goes in front to Larry Robinson, the Big Bird. Gets his first goal of the year, and it's 1-1. Let's go to the second period. Robitaille will drop the puck to McSorley, who goes to Granato. He's got the empty net. 2-1 for the Kings. Let's go to the third period. The Wings will bounce back and tie it up. Sean Burr with a shot. Fedorov will tip it in front. He beats the Bandit, and it's 2-2. Again, the Kings come back to regain the lead. This time it's Gretzky to Curry. He fans on the initial shot, beats Cheveldayon the backhander. 3-2. With the game now tied at 3, late in the third period, the Kings on the attack. Gretzky with the shot, but Cheveldaycomes up with an enormous glove grab right there. Now just over a minute left to play in the game. Bob Probert will take the pass, but he can't handle it. It goes off his skate. Kudelski picks it up. He tries the shot. It's blocked, but he in turn goes to Granato, who gets his second goal of the game. That made it 4-3, and that is your final tonight from the Murder City for the Kings. Larry Robinson, Tony Granato with 2, and Yari Curry for the Wings. Paul Eisbart, Sergei Fedorov, and Kevin Miller. Gretzky had 1 assist in the game. Now let's move on to a Norse division tilt as the Leafs were at home, yes, to the St. Louis Blues. Now after a slow start, the Blues are starting to pick it up. They were 5-1-2 in their last 8 games. Now just in case you missed it, by the way, Daniel Marois broke his right hand Friday. He's out indefinitely, as if the Leafs needed more injuries. Let's see how they did tonight as they took on their Norse division rivals. Early in the first period, Toronto will get on the board. Brian Bradley will find the twine as he beats Joseph, and it's 1-0. But the Blues come back to tie the game. Toronto can't clear. Adam Oates goes to Cavallini. Gino gets the goal, and it's 1-1. Now, late in the first period, Toronto on the attack. There's a mad scramble in front, but somehow, someway, Joseph will keep the puck out of the net. Let's go to the second period. Some tight checking and some good body checks. Sutter runs Michel Petit, knocking him through the ice. Now, later in the period, Mike Foligno turns Murray Barron inside out. He walks in all alone on Joseph, but he could not beat him. Joseph with a solid save right there. Now, early in the third period, the Blues had a great chance to take the lead. The Golden Brett will walk in all alone, but Grant Fear will stone him. Now, midway through the third period, the Leafs believe they take the lead. Zezel will feed Lysell in the slot. His shot will trickle in, but Mike Foligno was in the crease. They called the goal up. Not only did they call the goal off, but they also gave Foligno a penalty as well. The Blues could not score. They go into overtime, the final in this game, 1-1 for St. Louis. Gino Cavallini had their lone goal for the Leafs. It was Brian Bradley. Grant Fear stopped 16 shots. Curtis Joseph stopped 29. We had these comments following the game.
I was interfered with the defense, and I got turned around, and I backed in the goalie, but, you know, I was interfered with, and I always thought that if, you know, you are interfered with, then it's sort of waved off.
Now you got to love the, you know, the goal was called back because of it, but what a great rule for charge of the crease.
I've seen it happen against us quite a few times. I've never had it go for me, and I'm glad to get that call. And I think it was a good call because it was a slow roller, and the goalie's going to save it unless he's interfered with.
Well, you got to be pleased with getting the point, but you sure as hell aren't satisfied with the way your hockey club played tonight. And what people don't realize, and you never ever hear this said, but you have 1 point before the puck's dropped every night, and there's another point out there for both teams to go out and get. And I didn't think either team, it's a good thing the goaltender showed up and played hard.
Blues coming to town this Wednesday.